Hello friends, Namaste. In this session, we will be understanding about the various types of tourism which has emerged due to the requirement of travelers, the need to travel, and the various contemporary changes which we have witnessed in the world. So, let us see what are the various types of tourism.
Let's go through the first new trend, or which is the most popular trend, is ecotourism. Ecotourism, by the word itself, talks about ecological form of tourism. This is a concept which was emerged in 1980s in international countries, and which was gradually adopted in India since 2000 onwards. This is out of the need of sustainability that made the stakeholders feel responsible to save the environment, to work for the sustainability of the ecology. In ecotourism, which is under the umbrella of sustainable form of tourism, there are three principles, underlying principles, which is, the first one is, it should be a visit to natural areas with the concept of, or with the motive of, preservation and conservation of the environment and the ecology. Second is, it should contribute towards the development and the growth of local economy. That is, there should be no economy leakage. The benefits of revenue should go to the local bodies. Third is, it should educate the tourists, the stakeholders who are involved in the tourism product, to work more for the sustainability. So these are the three basic principles on which ecotourism works. As I have said, it has gained momentum since decades, maybe since from 2000 onwards in India. And there are many people where they talk about that this particular ecotourism is becoming just a fad, a fashion, where most of the working body wants to label themselves as ecotourism, but are they really following the practices or not is a matter of concern. There are various bodies who provide eco-certification to the working organizations towards ecotourism. Green Globe is one of the initial one which was started, and then there are various societies, to name the International Ecotourism Society. In India also we have Responsible Tourism Society of India, RTSOI. So these are the bodies which helps in promoting the concept of ecotourism. As I have already said, the third underlying principle of ecotourism is educational experience, which is of very, very high need, because if we are not educating the travelers, the people involved, to when they go to place and when they start looking for luxury and comfort without taking care of the carbon footprint, definitely it will disturb the ecology. So carbon footprint is a very important element which has to be considered in ecotourism. There should be minimum carbon footprint at a destination. Hence, ecotourism utilizes most of the traditional forms of travel arrangements, accommodation arrangements. It tries to use eco-friendly practices more. That is zero plastic, 3 R's of sustainability, reduce, reuse and recycle. And it comes up with the ethical approach towards the conserving of the local culture, especially if it is the attraction is near to a tribal place, it's where tribals are there. So the tribes' principles, their culture has to be preserved. As I said, maximizes local economic return. So the local body should get their benefit. There should be no economy leakage. That is, the economy, the money spent by the tourist should directly go to the local people residing at the place, rather than of being deviated to the various intermediaries who are in the system of tourism business. Here are few destinations, countries who are well known for their ecotourism practices. The pioneer one to start with ecotourism practices was Costa Rica, where it is known as even Mecca of ecotourism. Even Belize is also known for Mecca of ecotourism. Even India has initiated to some extent with ecotourism practices within the natural reserves. Brazil is well known for the ecotourism practices at their national parks. Then Ecuador, Kenya, Nepal, Peru, South Africa, these are some known places in ecotourism activities. We could see how the tourists were made to use the traditional mode of travel medium, bullock cart, horse cart, and they were mostly walking to the places. It has also been said that if you want to have your travel as sustainable, you have to give away luxury and comfort and get involved with the nature. So basically, we can see these are the activities which are involved in ecotourism. Know the nature, get involved with nature, educate yourself, give up comfort, luxury, and try to use whatever is available there at the place, and stop using energy-enabled comfort services. So go for carbon-neutral practices. The other thing is, the kind of market segment in ecotourism product is conscious travelers, travelers who are well aware about their contribution towards ecology, who know that they have to contribute towards the conservation and preservation of the ecology, generally takes up ecotourism product. The next trend in tourism sector is the cultural tourism. I would say that these are the types of tourisms which has emerged gradually. Cultural tourism was available since from Grand Tour era, where we have discussed that the Englishmen wanted to send their kids to know about the other states, their practices, their culture. And this is how cultural tourism came into existence. But now, when we say in this 21st century, there are some group of people who just want to know about the culture of a destination, the lifestyle of people, and they either go in groups or they look in for travel agents who provide such types of tourism services. So the main aim of this cultural tourism is it focuses on traditional communities who have diverse customs, unique form of art, and distinct social practices, which basically distinguishes it from other types forms of culture. We have seen in Rajasthan, tourist wants to go to Rajasthan, tourist wants to go to UP to see the culture, to see the religious festival, to see the monuments, and they try to educate themselves accordingly. Rome is also known as one of the cultural tourism destinations. It is also been observed that this form of tourism is becoming more popular because of the purpose of tourists to know particular destination based on its culture. Next form of tourism is rural tourism. This is another emerging type where, because of tourists becoming conscious and they want to know how their community who are in rural areas, villages, live, what kind of lifestyle they have. They want to go and experience that. They want to relieve themselves from this busy life of urban cities, this lifestyle, the stress they carry. That is the reason rural tourism is in demand. There in Austria, we have seen that 21,000 farms are providing 1,09,000 rooms to farm tourists in 1994. This is the data of 1994, and which has exponentially grown in these years. So this is a kind of demand in the market. Now, when we talk about the activities which a tourist get involved in rural tourism is immersing themselves into the lifestyle of the rural people, understanding the rural activities of living, that is the agriculture, the handicrafts, the sports activity, the food, what kind of food they make, how they make, and enjoying those food. So here in rural tourism, you'll find that the travelers have no expectation of luxury lifestyle, and they would prefer staying in a home which has been run by the rural people. So the homestays are in demand in rural tourism category. The tourists get involved into hiking, biking, and visiting of museums. The next form of tourism is adventure tourism. This was since from long, when we talk about during our ancestors' time, during the Homo sapiens time, where the ancestors were exploring, they were trying to learn various activities, and they had involved themselves into various fun activities, various sports activities of trying to learn how to swim, how to dive, how to that time even hunting of animals was involved, but now it's one of the illegal form of practices. When we say adventure tourism, it is popularly been accepted in the market of youngsters age group, especially where the youngsters in the age group of 13 plus to 30 years want to explore or make themselves get engrossed into adventure activity. And there are exceptional cases of 40 plus, 50 plus age group also getting involved into adventure tourism activities. Basically, they try to explore sports events of, say, water game based, or they try to get involved into forest activities of safari, trekking. Then they get involved into scuba diving, bungee jumping, skydiving, and many more such type of adventure activities. A person who is providing adventure tourism product should have certified trainers to provide these services to the tourists. And basically, adventure tourism is being found in places which are near to water bodies or in hill stations, or natural places like national park for safari activities. And Africa is known for their wildlife and adventure tourism products. Next form of tourism, which has taken its shape since from 2005 onwards, is health tourism, where under this category, there are two forms of tourism. One is medical tourism, the other one is wellness tourism. When we say medical tourism, is where the tourists get involved into invasive forms of medical treatment, where there is a surgery involved, there is a kind of activities involved, visiting to hospitals, and a long term of medications are involved. And when we talk about wellness tourism is where a person, the tourist himself, gets involved into spiritual meditation or say rejuvenating kind of practices. So here, when we say health tourism, it refers to travel to facilities and destinations for obtaining healthcare services or health related benefit. We have seen that India is one of the popular known destination because of its low cost medical facilities availability in India. And there are other destinations in US, UK, which are also known for their medical centers. So India, Cuba, Colombia, Hungary, Malaysia, Philippines, Singapore, South Africa and Thailand are also worldwide known destination for medical travel. And when we talk about the history point of view, medical tourism dates back to thousands of years when the Greek pilgrims traveled from all over the Mediterranean to the small territory in the Saronic Gulf called Epidoira for their treatments. And there were like spa towns which were emerging to provide wellness kind of activities. So as I've said, health tourism has three main forms: medical care, fitness and wellness, rehabilitation and recuperation activities. New age tourism. What is new age tourism? New age tourism is the kind of tourism which has emerged in this 21st century, where there's a movement of people where they want to know the ancient cultures, go into spirituality, metaphysics, yoga, healing, herbology, communion. So it's all based on their special interest when they visit to a place. There are, as I've already said, in the health tourism, wellness tourism is being demanded a lot because of the kind of stress tourists have, people have. So they want to get it relieved and relive their life. So wellness tourism comes under new age tourism category. Dark tourism comes under new age tourism category. Space tourism comes under new age tourism category. So we will discuss in detail the other forms of new age tourism. So wellness tourism, which is under health tourism and it comes under new age tourism category also. You can see that it is motivated by a desire for healthy living, disease prevention, stress reduction, management of poor lifestyle habits, and for real experiences. Whereas in medical, it is getting a treatment for a disease in a particular hospital at a renowned place. So this is the major difference. The activities in wellness tourism is the tourist is proactive. He wants to volunteer for those activities and it is non-invasive and non-medical in nature. And because of this COVID pandemic time, this wellness tourism is in demand, whereas where most of the people wants to go to a calm place where they can relieve their stress and rejuvenate themselves and come back. And because of this opportunity in this pandemic time, there are many tourism and hospitality sectors which are shifting their products to wellness tourism category. Educational tourism, by the word itself, here the market segment is the youngsters or research scholars or people who are involved into attaining some form of degree or a kind of certification program where they go to another destination for study purposes and they try to get indulge into the tourism activities in those destinations. It is a, as we have seen, it happened in Grand Tour era itself. It was a cultural and educational form of tourism practices. And you'll find there are people who go for exploration activity. They go to places for their research activities, say for a historical place or in a park, in a national areas, national park areas, to know the habitat of that place. So that comes under educational tourism. Space tourism. I have said many a times in the earlier sessions as well that space tourism is the future, where companies like Virgin Galactic, SpaceX by Tesla, Blue Origin, and then Orion Span, Space Hotel has also come up. They want to give some technological based advanced recreational services to people who wants to go out of the world and see how universe looks like. So it's like it could be in orbital form or suborbital form and lunar space tourism activity. So it depends on what kind of activities they will make their market segment, the tourists get involved into it. Now the market segment, the demand of space tourism is to be seen in elite category of people amongst billionaires who can afford this kind of product. And there are lots of billionaires who have already invested in Virgin Galactic experiments as well as in SpaceX experiments. Virgin Galactic has had the mission of starting this space tourism in 2020, but their test was failed and they could have a flight only for some few minutes with two people. Still, they are working on it and they may soon come with a space fleet for space tourism activity. The other form of tourism which we'll be discussing is MICE tourism. MICE tourism, which was prior to COVID-19, which was being utilized by maximum people for their businesses, incentives, conference and exhibitions activities. Now, because of the travel restrictions, it has been halted. There is very less contribution towards MICE activities. The market segment for MICE tourism product was business travelers who intended to go to various destinations for their conferences, summits, exhibitions. And they had a well-planned agenda. And they were a kind of, tourist who wants to expend more and get services, luxury services in return. And it was majorly in form of groups where the officials used to go for conferences, seminars, exhibitions purposes. Under tourism, in my previous sessions also I have spoken about under tourism. Under tourism in recent years have been crumbling and it's like trying to get its form because of the weight or the disaster which has happened due to mass tourism. So there are many tourists who wants to explore destinations which is unexplored and which is where they can educate themselves, where they can try to get involved into immersed experience feeling in that particular place. So when we talk about it, is a less under tourism is a less known phenomenon, but it encourages travelers to choose less popular destination as an alternative to over touristed cities. So this is the basic purpose of under tourism. And here you will find market segment are like conscious travelers who wants to get some privacy, who don't want to go to highly populated tourist places. And cities such as Paris, Venice, Barcelona, Bruges, Dubrovnik, Kyoto, they want to reduce the tourist influx. So that they have started trying to give other destinations a chance to deliver the services to the tourists. Dark tourism, greed tourism, or thanatourism. This is the trend which has emerged. It's like it was there in 1990s when people started visiting to places which were associated with some kind of tragedy, some death. And thanatos means death. There are some ethical issues on practicing this tourism product, that it talks about whether it is good to provide activities to tourists to go to such places where some tragedy has happened and exploit the people who are available, the deceased people. So there's a ethical issue governing to this form of tourism. So the basic definition of dark tourism is visiting to disaster sites and turning the tragedies into tourist attraction, where the tourists try to understand what happened in the history, then how many people were killed, and what were the aftermaths of the disasters, the war which has happened. The battlefields of Culloden in Scotland and in Japan, you can talk about the Hiroshima Nagasaki attack and the war zone areas. All these places are associated with thanatourism, grief tourism, or dark tourism. The scholar says, rather than of promoting dark tourism, we can take another step of peace tourism, where we can introduce an educational trip to such places, but try to make tourists understand that the incident happened in the history were wrong, and how they have created a massive bad impact onto the society, and make them get involved into peace practices like mingling with the community people, contributing towards the affected society, coming up some peace parks. So this is another thought which has been in discussion in various tourism conferences and seminars. Wildlife tourism, which comes under the category of nature tourism, is where the tourists who are animal lovers, who tries to get involved into natural habitat, who makes themselves get acquainted with knowing animals, loving the nature, is trying to have themselves involved into wildlife tourism. There are various places which are well known for wildlife tourism. Countries like African, South American countries, India, Canada, Indonesia, Bangladesh, Australia, and many more. The activities involved, as I've already said, that the nature lover, the wildlife lover, they take photographs, they learn about the species, they take use of guide services in the safari, in the park, and they visit to all these natural parks, zoos, with their families, taking shape where people, the foodies, food lovers, wants to visit places which are known for food. So this is another trend which will be seen in next few years, and there are many more.
The other emerging trends in tourism are enotourism, that is wine tourism or vinotourism. In this form of tourism, it involves tasting of wine, the purchase of wine, and the tourist visits to wineries to have a glimpse of the vineyards, get involved into the process of harvesting, get the knowledge of harvesting process and wine making process. Most of the top destinations in the world are in France, Portugal, Greece, Italy, Argentina, Australia, South Africa, Spain, New Zealand, and in India, Karnataka, Nashik are known places for wine tourism. The next form of tourism which is emerging is ghetto tourism, or it is also known as slum tourism. It means visiting to a slum area and trying to understand the lifestyle of deprived, socially deprived people, and contributing towards their growth, development, or for some education activity. The known places in ghetto tourism when we talk about is the Dharavi slum in Mumbai, and most of the places in Brazil, Africa, and many more. Next emerging trend is
fashion tourism. Fashion tourism is visiting to a place which is known for fashion. There the tourists get involved into shopping and cultural forms of activities. The top fashion destinations in the world are New York, Paris, Barcelona, London, Rome, Milan, Los Angeles, and many more. Have you heard about genealogy tourism? Genealogy tourism is knowing about your roots of the family. It is also called as roots tourism, where the tourists travel to their ancestral place to get reconnected with their past or to walk in the footsteps of their ancestors. It is a worldwide industry and prominent in countries that have experienced mass immigration. So in genealogy tourism, people try to find their heritage, and we can even, if those who are aware, there is a site which is called as myheritage.com, where we can try to find where our ancestors are rooted. Next form of tourism is geotourism. Geotourism, according to National Geographic Society, it is a form of tourism which sustains or enhances the distinctive geographical character of a place, that is its environment, heritage, aesthetics, culture, and the well-being of its residents. The top geotourism destinations in the world are Sierra Nevada, Wild Delaware River, Heart of the Continent, Crown of the Continent, Lakes to Locks Passage, Sedona Verde, Four Corners, and Bahamas. A known form of tourism is sports tourism, where the sports lovers visit to places to enjoy the mega events of sports, specifically of Olympic Games, FIFA World Cup, F1 Grand Prix, World Tennis Championship, then Cricket World Cup. In this, the tourists get themselves involved into the sports activities, enjoy the attractions of the destinations. It has been observed that by observing or participating in the sporting event, the tourist gets the feeling of sports and they expend a lot in this form of tourism. It is one of the fastest growing sectors and equates to around $7.68 billion, which is a huge amount. Sports tourism is also classified into sports event tourism, and celebrity is involved into sport tourism to capture the attention of the sport lovers. The other form of tourism is film tourism. In film tourism, the tourist visits to places which are known for the sets where the film was picturized. They try to visit in a places which is highly known for good sets. For a good example here is the Harry Potter sets, Lord of the Rings set, then Switzerland sets, visiting stately homes in the Jane Austen movies, touring London in high-speed boats like James Bond are good examples of film tourism. Have you heard about community-based tourism? Community-based tourism is an alternative type of tourism where the localites are fully involved in rendering the services of tourism product, and the tourist themselves wants the service provided by the localites. In community-based tourism, both the tourist and the local are involved in getting and rendering the services of tourism. Community-based tourism is also been accepted under the form of rural tourism or in ecotourism category. Virtual tourism, which is becoming the next boom in the market, because of the availability of advanced technology, virtual reality, where it allows the travelers to explore a place without physically traveling via a smartphone or a computer. There would be VR devices where the travelers need to wear and gets that immersed experience of the place. Such type of tours are created with 3D models and have a sequence of hyperlink still or video images and image-based models of the real world along with some sound effects and text. So virtual reality tourism is the next boom in the market. I hope you would have liked the session. If you have any queries or you would like to comment about the session, please write to me or put your comments in the comment section. Thank you.
So this is all about today's session. The references which were used for this session are given below.